My lover's got humor. She's the giggle at a funeral. Knows everybody's disapproval. I should've worshipped her sooner. If the heavens ever did speak, she's the last true mouthpiece. Every Sunday's getting more bleak. A fresh poison each week. We were born sick, you heard them say it. My church offers no absolutes. She tells me worship in the bedroom. The only heaven I'll be sent to is when I'm alone with you. I was born sick, but I love it. Command me to be well. Amen. 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 Take me to church. I worship like a dog at the shrine of your life. I'll tell you my sins and you can sharpen your knife. Offer me that deathless death, the good God. Let me give you my life. Take me to church. I worship like a dog.
Decided, you know what, I'm going to do a Django Unchained review, because it's probably my favorite movie of all time. And if it's not my favorite movie of all time, it's definitely in that, like, top two category, where it's either that or this other film that I will eventually get around to doing a review of, but today is not that day. So, and actually, of the two films that I kind of consider my favorite films of all time, I do believe that Django is more watchable and easier to digest for, like, a mainstream public. The only problem, ultimately, with Django is that it's 2 hours and 40 minutes long, and it's really violent and about kind of a touchy subject. Now, you know, slavery. And that being said, I think fundamentally, like, the violence is totally doable. Like, it's not... It's one of those things where it's like you should be able to handle it, and most people should be able to handle it, because a lot of the violence is implied and not truly shown. And... I mean, while the film is harsh, you need that for the ride. Like, anything other than a harsh ride with a film dealing about slavery would be really dishonest and very uncomfortable. but ultimately, Django has this backdrop of slavery, and really it's a love story, and it's just very epic, and just one of the best adventure action movies I've seen in forever. And it's truly one of those movies where I mean, earlier today when I was watching it, I've seen it, like, I know it like the back of my hand, and I've watched that movie like 12 times, and when I was putting it on today, I really just sat through the whole thing, and I wasn't intending on that. Like, I was intending on just grabbing a couple clips and then getting this review done, but I ended up sitting there for 2 hours and 40 minutes. I didn't skip a single scene, and I was planning on it, but I really didn't. Like, I just sat through and watched the whole thing and was just like, wow, you know, like, this thing is a masterpiece. Like, it really is. It's Quentin Tarantino's best work, and if you don't like Quentin Tarantino, really, I recommend you check out Django. And it's just his masterpiece. Like, if he died tomorrow, I think everything would be fine. I'm not rooting for Quentin Tarantino to die, don't get me wrong, I really like the guy. But if he were hypothetically to die tomorrow, the man made freaking Django and was really at the top of his game. And I feel like he made that movie that encapsulates everything that, you know, we need in a movie as moviegoers. You know, like the whole shebang, you know, like the humor, the horror, the adventure, the excitement, the good, the evil, the open expanses, the cinematography, the way it's edited, the music. That intro sequence might seem long, but I had my roommate look at it, and he's seen the movie a bunch of times, and I was like, do you think this spoils the movie, like the things I'm showing? And he was like, no, honestly, you didn't show, and then he listed off so many things. He's like, you didn't show a lot of main characters, you didn't show all the action scenes, you didn't even show the last action scene, actually. So he was like, no, you didn't give away... He almost said that people might be confused if they just watched the intro. He's like, they might not know this is about slavery and the Wild West, actually, because it's so vague. But I think, ultimately, I'm trying not to do a spoiler review, and I don't particularly want to do a spoiler review, even though normally I like to do spoilers, but I feel like for this film, just go check it out. And there's nothing I can say about this film that will do it justice. Like, it is one of those things where I highly recommend you try to sit through it. If you get through it, you will experience something that you probably will never forget for the rest of your life, and I just can't recommend it enough. And there's nothing I can say that does this film... I can't use my words to actually articulate how good it is, but truly, it is one of the greatest films I've ever seen, and I cannot recommend it enough. And go check out Django Unchained. It is a hard R, but grow a pair, deal with it. Like, it's a sweet ride, and I cannot just say enough nice things about it. So, Quentin Tarantino, you're the man, and Leonardo DiCaprio probably should have won an Academy Award for this movie, but he didn't, and if you hate Jamie Foxx, you'll probably love him after this movie, actually. So, truly, go check out Django, and I don't know. We'll talk about it later.